And welcome back to Sports Weekly on IEMG. How about some high school baseball highlights on this show? One of the top teams in the area. You could even say the Southern Section, the state, however you slice it. The Aquinas Falcons are the real deal this season. The Falcons in action against Colton High School in non-league play this past Saturday. Bottom half of the first inning. Here is the leadoff batter for the Falcons, Eric Batanti, one of the top players in the entire country. Leads off the game with a solo home run. So that's how the party started for the Aquinas Falcons, and they would add some runs to that for sure, padding their lead on the Yellow Jackets. Cody Camille getting the start, the strikeout there for Cody in the first inning. And then later in the second, the Falcons are back for more on the scoreboard. Caden Williford, the sack fly to left. Josh Cunningham tags up and scores. And the error on the throw back home will allow Batanti to come home as well. 3-0 Aquinas in front of Colton. Later, it's going to be number 44, Cade Nolan at the plate. And Nolan's going to smack this double. Here it goes into the left center field gap. Seth Rajasic is going to score on this play. And the Falcons, they built a 3-0 lead, a 4-0 lead, a 5-0 lead. They were running away from the Colton Yellow Jackets in this one. Following up is Landon Young. Roping the ground rule double deep to left center field. It hops over the wall. The easy double for Landon Young. And then it's going to be Williford popping up again. Watch this play here. So Williford at the plate pops it up to the right side. Good play by the first baseman to make the play. But as he's falling down, trying to throw to the plate to get Landon Young tagging up for third. But the throw gets away. Landon Young scores. And two more right behind him, including Batanti. So with the bases loaded, everybody comes home on that sack fly from Williford. Aquinas goes on to defeat Colton High School by a final score of 10-0. So with that win, the Falcons improved to 11-0 overall on the season. They've also had a couple league games. Aquinas 2-0 in the Ambassador League with wins against two very good teams, Woodcrest Christian and Arrowhead Christian. So congratulations to Aquinas. A hot start this season and a big win. Colton 10-0, the final score in that one. All right, so last season, the Aquinas Falcons won their first league championship since 1997. In fact, I believe this was the exact game and the exact play when the Falcons clinched that league championship. So their first league title in a long time, again, 97. So they were Ambassador League champions last year, and they're trying to do it all over again. We had a chance to catch up with head coach Mike Carpentier of the Aquinas Falcons. Talk about championship chasing at Aquinas. We're out here at Aquinas High School with Falcons skipper Mike Carpentier and coach. Today you guys beat Colton 10-0, but I feel like there's still some areas that you guys can still get better, still clean up. We haven't seen maybe the best version of Aquinas yet.
Yeah, we decided to go with freshman Cody Kimley today, which keep the innings down on some of the bigger, older guys. He pitched very well today. Obviously, the competition level is going to get a lot better as we move forward and get later on in the season. But I thought we played well today. I thought we swung the bat well. Trying to focus a little bit more on better hitting counts. That's what we've been focusing on. You know, we're such a young group with one or two seniors and a couple juniors and everybody else being young. The immaturity shows sometimes, so that's where we're at.
Coach, you go right into my next question. You know, when you look at this lineup, you've got so many young guys out there seeing, you know, significant playing time, you know, key players out there in the field, in your batting order. You're set up for a couple seasons, not just this year, but years, you know, into the future. What does it say about the mix that you have of just young guys coming up that Aquinas is going to be pretty good for a while?
Well, like today, we sent a team out to play JV, and sometimes putting those rosters together are tough because there's so much young talent here. I think we started one senior today and a couple juniors and a lot of sophomores, and actually had three freshmen in the lineup today, which is good for the program, good for the future, and it's going to be like that for the next couple of years. A lot of youngsters coming in, a lot of the same faces staying around ready to play. So,
well, I know you got several special players, Eric Batanti leading the way. What can you say about Eric, and what do you think makes him just a special, unique ball player? I know obviously when you look at him, he passes the eye test. He's bigger than everybody else. But what do you think makes him a special player?
The big thing with Eric is he brings leadership. He brings energy every day to the field. First of all, it starts in the classroom, starts at home, starts with the way he treats the youngsters. just a complete leader all the way around. Obviously on the field, it speaks for itself. It's a different situation. You don't see those kind of guys come around very often, and it's just special, and I'm fortunate and lucky to have him in my program.
So, Coach, last year you guys win a league championship. You get to the playoffs. First, it was the first league title, what, since 97, I want to say. Does that sound about right?
Yeah.
So going into this year, was the expectations, the mindset a little bit different based on the success that you guys had last season?
Yeah, last year what I really noticed is we scored a lot of runs early. We had four freshmen and four sophomores in the lineup last year. Our big fall was to lift 5 days a week. We got in the weight room this year really early in September. We've been lifting for about 5 months straight, almost every single day. Last year, towards the end of the season, my youngsters, they weren't able to keep up. And that's kind of what we wanted to change this year, is to be a lot more physical and a lot stronger. And over the 5 months, you can see the bodies changed. The ball's coming out better. The ball's coming out the bat a lot better. So that was kind of the big thing we thought was different from last year to this year, mm-hmm. was making a change in the strength program, and we've done a good job of that, and we're going to continue to lift and get stronger, and with the young guys, that's kind of what you got to do to keep up.
So, Coach, I believe you guys are still undefeated, right?
Yeah,
on the season.
Right now, we've had some games. We had a tough game against Woodcrest the other day where we were down 7-1 early, and the youngsters didn't give up. Fought until we got into the seventh, down two, and put together about 7 or 8 hits in a row. And made a good comeback. It was a real wind-aided game, 40-mile-an-hour winds blowing out. They were a little bit fortunate to play the wind a little bit better than we were. But in the end, you know, it's what matters.
You know, Coach, we spend a lot of time talking about the Citrus Belt League, the Big 8 League, some of those leagues here in the Inland Empire, but the Ambassador League, that's pretty good baseball as well.
Well, yeah, no, Woodcrest, Ontario Christian, Western's getting a lot better, Linfield's gotten a lot better. Our league is tough. We spent the whole fall, we were lucky enough to play Orange Loose, Bishop Gorman, some of the bigger schools, just to get ready for the regular season. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's a little bit about being battle tested. And sometimes, you know, the mentality part, it makes you a little stronger playing against those guys when you go into some of these other games and feel like you can play with anybody out there. You know, they're young, so the mentality part has to be a lot stronger.
All right, finally, Coach, finish this sentence. The Aquinas, in order for the Aquinas Falcons to win league and make a deep run in CIF, we need to do...
We need to compete. That's the bottom line. We need to compete every inning, every game, and not take anything for granted.
Coach Carp, always appreciate the time, brother. Appreciate it. Coach Carpentier here at Aquinas High School on Sports Weekly on IEMG.
This is a very talented Aquinas baseball team. I got a feeling we'll be talking much more about the Falcons here on Sports Weekly this season. When we come back, your March Madness college hoops here locally for San Bernardino Valley College and also Cal State San Bernardino. Those highlights when we come back here on Sports Weekly on IEMG.